here is what I've decided to do. I will bring suffering on the people of Judah and Jerusalem, and no one will escape. They will beg me to help, but I won't listen to their prayers. Then they will offer sacrifices to their other gods and ask them for help. After all, the people of Judah have more gods than towns, and more altars for Baal than there are streets in Jerusalem. But those gods won't be able to rescue the people of Judah from disaster. Jeremiah, don't pray for these people or beg me to rescue them. If you do, I won't listen, and I certainly won't listen if they pray. Those words come from Jeremiah chapter 11, verses 11 to 14. When the doctor arrives in your hospital room and delivers the diagnosis of your condition, he might say, "There are several possible solutions to your problem, and we must pick one to try first." When turning to God is one of a number of possible solutions to the problems in your life, the Bible gives no promise of a positive response by the Creator. Even when you try God first and hold in your heart the possibility of doing something else, if God doesn't work, don't expect to see God respond. There are times when God has promised not to listen to prayers. The sinner's prayer will not impress God unless the sinner's heart is lying prostrate before Him in a full state of repentance. The prayer you pray means nothing without a contrite heart. Certainly, it is important to work on your prayer life, but it is more important to work on your heart life. When you hold other options in your heart, Jesus will wait till your heart is completely focused on Him and has given up all others for Him alone. Lord Jesus, You are not just the best hope in the world. You, Jesus, are the only hope for everyone on earth. Praise Your holy name now and forever. Amen.